Good morning, markers. Please stand for morning prayer. O suffering Jesus, we give you glory, thanks, and praise. Today concludes National Suicide Prevention Month. God, we pray, be with all of us in our difficult times. Whatever is weighing me down, whether it is something big or something small, when I find myself surrounded by darkness, God, lift my head up. Turn my eyes. Help me to notice not just the darkness, but the light in the distance. Give me the strength, whatever I may be going through, to stand on my feet and take one step at a time each day until that light gets nearer and nearer, bigger and bigger, brighter and brighter. As I walk my journey each day, God, turn my eyes not just to the light at the end of the tunnel, but even to the light coming through the cracks in the walls beside me. Help me to see the light of love from family, friends, even strangers who love me as I am and believe in me. Help me to feel the warmth of that light and remind me that you will never leave me to face my troubles alone. Help me to trust you always. Though I may seem lost at times, I will not fear, for you are ever with me, and you will never leave me to face my challenges alone. And the people say,
good morning, Nerinx Hall. This is NERX TV, your high school madness and information station. And now it's time for your wake-up call.
Good morning, Nerinx Hall.
Today is Thursday, September 30th.
I'm Cece.
And I'm Paige.
And now to People with Sports.
Good morning, Marker fans. I'm McKenna.
And I'm Marissa. Now for some results. The freshman field hockey team defeated Eureka 1-0. The golf team scores St. Joe 147, MICDS 184, Nerinx 195. Nerinx medalist Zoe Geiser with a 39. Today's sports, the tennis team begins districts today at Webster Tennis Complex at 3 p.m. Good luck, markers. The varsity and JV and freshman volleyball teams play Lutheran South at Nerinx. Freshman at 4 p.m., JV 5:30, and varsity at 6:45. The golf team plays Villa at Forest Hills at 3:45 p.m. The tennis team, the JV tennis team, plays Villa at 5:30 p.m.
And now for tomorrow's sports. The tennis team continues in the tennis districts at Webster Tennis Complex. And now for weekend sports, the freshman volleyball team plays in the Charger Tournament. The cross-country team travels to Louisville to run in the Greater Louisville Race. And the varsity and JV field hockey teams play John Burroughs. Varsity at noon, JV at 10:30 a.m. at Burroughs. Now for a joke. What do you get when you cross a snowman with a vampire?
I don't know.
Frostbite. Thanks, Sam.
Back to the Acres.
Great game day, markers. And now to Sarah with Info Report.
After listening to your favorite song, you'll most likely feel happy or motivated. But why? When listening to music, your brain releases dopamine, which is a chemical that plays a big part in how we are able to focus on tasks and process information and emotions. A part of the brain that is affected by dopamine is the hippocampus, which works with learning and memory. A lot of the time, patients with Alzheimer's, who are also musicians in their youth, are known to be able to completely replay songs they had learned years ago. As seen in the picture, not only does it affect the hippocampus, but it stimulates and increases engagement in many other parts of the brain. Back in 2006, a group of scientists and musicians gathered at Stanford Center for Computer Research in Music and Acoustics. The meeting organizer, Gabe Turow, stated that listening to music seems to be able to change brain functioning to the same extent as medication in many circumstances. Attention Deficit Hyperactivity Disorder, or ADHD, is thought to be caused by the lack of dopamine. This is why, in many cases, listening to music can help people who struggle with ADHD focus. You may be thinking, I can't focus to music with words, or I have to have pop music on when I'm studying. This is all due to, like, your personal preference. There's no definite genre that will make every person concentrate. In 2018, a TED Talk, Alan Harvey did a live experiment to see how different music affects the brain. Let's take a look.
He is at peace. He loves this piece. It's really calm. Loves it.
Thank you.
Well, I don't know. There was.
Even if you don't have the fancy equipment, go perform an experiment and listen to your favorite song today. Thanks, and back to the anchors.
Juniors and seniors, representatives from the University of Kansas, the University of Nebraska, and Central Methodist University will be in the Student Success Center today during contact. Interested students should sign up on SCORE. Thank you, Ms. Sumter and Mrs. Carr.
And now to Mr. Zagel with Campus Ministry.
Hey everybody, we are wrapping up Spirit Week tomorrow with Mass, celebrating Father Nerinx's birthday, which is on Saturday. I, for one, think it's hilarious that it's also Pajama Day tomorrow, so we'll all be in our pajamas for Mass, only at Nerinx. So that'll be awesome. On a more serious note, generally speaking, our behavior at Mass is pretty solid, right? But there are definitely times where we get chatty, and it's not okay. You know it's not okay. I know it's not okay, especially during communion. We really, really, really need to be better at that, okay? So let's have a great Mass tomorrow. Let's act how we know we should act from start to finish, and have just a good celebration tomorrow to wrap up the Spirit Week with gratitude and thanksgiving. And hey, if you don't pray often, maybe tomorrow's a good day to start. Maybe you could pray for no rain at fall ball. I don't really think that's the kind of prayer that God answers, but it can't hurt to try. So, looking forward to a great Mass tomorrow. No rain at fall ball. Thanks, and back to the anchors.
Tonight we have a summer humanities meeting. Where? In the art room. When? Six o'clock to seven. Who? Parents and students wanting to enroll in the summer humanities course and European trip. What will be discussed? The course, including the course, registration, and Nerinx policies. Being an art camp counselor in camp and art camp, the trip, itinerary, details about the trip, traveling with COVID, parents traveling, and any questions you have. Questions, or if you cannot attend, please email Mr. Hunt. Thank you, Mr. Hunt.
And now to Dr. Smith with culture and conservational norms.
Howdy, y'all. I'm Dr. Smith from the library, and I'm here to start our conversation on our cultural and conversational norms. It's based on the acronym MARKERS, and I'm going to start off today with M, make valid statements. That's just to make statements that are justifiable, logically correct, and just make sense. But there are three bullet points, so let's get into them. First of all, engage in meaningful dialogue and discussion that allows for a logical premise or conclusion. So this means equitably participate. Don't feel as though you can't contribute, but don't monopolize a conversation either. And use logical ideas to lead to your conclusion. For example, only faculty, students, and staff can access the library databases at Nerinx Hall. Mr. Zagel can access the library databases. Therefore, Mr. Zagel is obviously a student, faculty member, or staff member at Nerinx Hall. You can also choose statements that are grounded in empirical evidence that have been tested and proven through research or scientific inquiry. That means in addition to basing your conclusions on logic, you can base them on verifiable, observable fact or experiences. For example, say you want to eat your cookies, your delicious cookies from contact, and you think, maybe I should go to the library to eat those cookies. But you know that I've told you, no, you can't eat in the library. And you've also been told you can't eat in the hallways or the classrooms. But it's raining outside. So where can we go? The cafeteria. Third point and last point. Expect others to believe the validity of your statements and believe the validity of other statements. And basically that just boils down to be respectful, be kind to each other. And that concludes our first conversational and cultural norm, make valid statements. So go forth, make valid statements, and back to the anchors.
Today's birthdays are Lily Barksdale and Belle Nugan. Happy birthday.
And now to the Loretto leaders.
Hi everyone, we're excited to announce this year's recipients of the Loretto Leader Award. These folks nominated by you and then selected by the students on the Loretto Leader Selection Committee as people who embody the Loretto values of faith, community, justice, and respect.
From the freshman class of 2025, this marker is faithfully devoted to her family, her friends, and her commitments. She took on the role of assistant stage manager for the fall play as a freshman, a huge responsibility. She's reliable, follows through wholeheartedly, and works to create a positive environment with everything she's involved in. She never expects recognition or thank you, but is truly happy just to help others. She's an incredibly sweet, wholesome person that only wants the best for everyone she meets. Give it up for our Loretto leader from the class of 2025, Ava Yu.
From the sophomore class, this Loretto leader often offers to lead prayer. She is actively learning and growing, exploring life and exploring her faith. She is never scared to show that in front of her peers, and she is deeply committed to making sure other people feel valued. She'll never pass up an opportunity to make someone feel loved and accepted, giving compliments every day and offering advice and love when someone needs help. Join me in congratulating the Loretto leader from the class of 2024, Riley Hill. From the class of 2023, this marker is active in her faith and active in campus ministry at Nerinx. She always does what is right, even when no one is looking. She's always kind and always has the biggest smile on her face. She's always helping others and making sure other people are okay and feeling their best. Let's give it up for the Loretto leader from the class of 2023, Maggie Blankey.
For the class of 2022, this was the hardest decision because a ton of people were being considered. But we went with this Loretto leader because she's a cheerleader for everyone always. She is such an amazing person because she's down to talk to anyone about anything at any time. And she always makes sure you feel appreciated and welcomed. She's always humble and willing to help quietly without recognition, even if it's something as simple as putting away equipment during orchestra. Give it up for our Loretto leader from the class of 2022, Matilda Wenzein. This faculty member is very cheerful and funny. She's got great Miss Frizzle vibes in the best way. She's super caring and looks out for everybody, even offering to pay lunch for those who forgot. She takes a very personal interest in everybody and is great about trying to learn names in classes despite masks. She is always available for help and will go out of her way to help you. Congratulations to our faculty Loretto leader, Dr. Trung. Thanks, and back to the anchors.
Okay. Friendly reminder to neighborhoods. Household logo designs are due tomorrow, October 1st. So check with your household group and make sure your design is finished and ready to submit. The winning household will get their design screen printed on shirts, and your neighborhood will get their flag raised, along with serious neighborhood bragging rights. Mrs. Teeter emailed a reminder with all the info and guidelines on Tuesday, so be sure to check your emails if you have any questions. Completed designs should be emailed to your moderator or Mrs. Teeter by the end of the day, Friday.
And now to Ms. Newsham with French Exchange.
Good morning, Narc Markers. Bonjour, Nerinx. Joyeux jeudi. Happy Thursday. In case you don't know me, I'm Madame Newsham, and I am in charge of our French exchange program with the Lycée Notre-Dame, Notre Dame High School in Chartres, which is about an hour outside of Paris. We couldn't travel during the pandemic, but we're up and running for 2022. The French kids from Notre Dame, from Chartres, will be coming to visit us around Easter time from April 6th through the 20th. And then we, their pen pals, will go and visit them from May 29th until June 19th. We have about 2 weeks in and around Chartres in our host families with them before having our last 6 days and five nights entirely in Paris. This is a wonderful, life-changing experience. The French Club will be hosting a meeting about the exchange a week from tomorrow on October 8th, and there will be a mandatory parent meeting on Monday night, October 18th. You will see flyers around school, so please make a note of those dates, and don't hesitate to reach out to me in the meantime if you have any questions at all about the exchange. We hope to see all of you at these meetings, and with that, back to the anchors.
Today's lunch is Taco Madness, so be sure to go down to the cafeteria and get your tacos.
And now to Kara with Spirit Week.
Hi, guys. Happy holidays. I'm Kara.
And I'm Marissa.
And
we have some Spirit Week announcements. Our theme for today is Dress Like Your Favorite Holiday. As you can see, Kara and I are both dressed as Christmas, favorite holidays. That's very nice. The activities we have, Kara's gonna tell
us
about.
We have a live nativity scene at lunch.
AKA petting zoo. We're gonna
Everybody's
have donkeys,
so excited.
Bunnies, pigs, so get ready, get excited.
And thank you, Father Nerinx, for being birthed on Saturday, I think. Mm-hmm. Because we get free tacos today, woo! And tonight is the spirit game. It's at Nerinx at 6:30, the volleyball game. Everybody should come out for the spirit game, mm-hmm. and you get entered in a drawing to win a $50 Crumble gift card if you show up. Yeah, I know. Marissa, you think you're going to win?
I think I'm going to win because I'm definitely going to be there.
Oh, me mm-hmm. too.
Mm-hmm. And some reminders. Make sure you have your date submit their proof of vaccination or a negative test before fall ball. Tomorrow, we got our last day of spirit week. We're going to wear PJs, and we have... for activities, mass. So
yeah.
Get excited for that, markers.
All right. Yeah, thanks, and back to the anchors.
Today's senior of the day is Sammy Loretta. So if you see her in the hall, ask her how much money she owes her friends.
Today is a G day, so have a...
Gotta go fast.
Gobble, gobble.
Ghostly.
G day.
Merry Christmas, Nerinx.